May 2018 horoscopes with Milada from Astrolada.com. And as you know, the big event in May 2018 is that Uranus, the planet, the big revolutionary changes, is moving into a new sign. We're going to speak about that, but mentioning Uranus, we're making a webinar with April on the 6th of May, which is 20% off if you order now, about Uranus changing signs and how it's going to affect you personally. And everyone who participates will be able to receive an email from us with a description of how Uranus will affect them personally, so they don't need to know any astrology and watch this part of the webinar that's most relevant for them. Take your seat on the webinar now when it's 20% off. And also, Levi is making a Vedic astrology foundational webinar for Western astrologers, so you'll be able to incorporate the most relevant, the most easy, but at the same time, most productive Vedic astrology techniques into your Western astrology practice. It's a 4-week workshop for $160 only, starting at the beginning of May, on the 5th of May, so check out that webinar as well. And at the end of May, I'm starting my foundational course all about the 12 houses, which is 50% off if you get it now. Again, sorry, not 50%, $50 off. And it's gonna last for 6 months. Check out all those classes. Libra, May 2018. Let's quickly go over how Uranus is going to influence you for the next 6-7 years, because it's going to be in your 8th house. And Uranus is the planet of radical changes that is just moving out in May now from your 7th house, where it's been for the last 7 years of relationships. So many of you who are Libra rising, sun or moon, at some point in the last 7 years, depending on your personal horoscope, had some radical transformation that happened in their personal life through other people, through a business partnership, through a marriage, breakup, or getting together with someone. Something very revolutionized, maybe someone totally changed their life in some way. For example, my husband is Libra ascendant, and exactly when Uranus transited over his 7th house, opposite the ascendant, this is when he met me and we married within a few months. So some people might get divorced, might have gotten divorced when Uranus was in their 7th house, or totally change and restructure their relationship. But now, and it's kind of sometimes can be a bit destructive depending on the personal horoscope. So some of you might have had a bit big ups and downs in their personal relationships. Of course, not through all the whole 7 years, but specifically when Uranus was passing opposite their sun, moon, or ascendant in Libra. But now it's coming out of the 7th house and it's gonna be in your 8th house from May 2018 till 2026. And I'm not saying that immediately you'll see those changes, but now in May, when a planet changes signs, you will see the change of wind, so to speak, and you'll get an inkling, maybe new ideas, maybe new inspirations, or kind of the setup for new developments that are going to affect your 8th house for the next 7-8 years. But thankfully, at least it will stop destabilizing your personal relationship now that Uranus comes out of your 7th house, or create too many unexpected situations, as it has been creating a lot of changes in your personal relationship. But going into the 8th house, let's see what will happen. Well, 8th house on the material level is resources that you have with your spouse, with your business partner, mutual resources, money that comes to you through others, or any kind of income, or not only money, but it can be possessions that somehow are connected between you and another person. It might be even bank loans, so it might be some state help that you're receiving, you know, money that you have not worked for, but somehow it is connected to you. And Uranus wants to revolutionize that over the next 7-8 years. So you can expect that maybe a partner, a business partner can appear that creates new income, or maybe a new idea can come into your life, that you collaborate with someone and that you use some innovative methods, because Uranus is about anything new. And new technology, new ideas, but that you combine your powers with someone else, because the 8th house is other people's resources, talents, you know, money, possessions, skills as well. And that you might combine your your own resources or talents with another person's, and they can suddenly shift your resources. They can be a sudden jump or a sudden big change in your financial situation, but it is connected somehow to other people. So what can happen? And Uranus starts moving things very fast. For example, you've been expecting some kind of mortgage, or you've been expecting some kind of a loan, or maybe you're hoping to receive some alimony from an ex-spouse, and now Uranus, when it moves to your house, can start moving those things very fast and give very quick resolutions to those things. In the best case scenario, you can have sudden rise of your finances, like sudden jump, because Uranus is a planet that doesn't do things gradually. All of a sudden, because of collaborating with another person, for example, but on the money negative level, if Uranus is going to be making difficult aspects from this 8th house for you Libras, it depends very much on your personal horoscope. Again, I repeat, there might be like a sudden discontinuation, for example, from support that you're receiving from someone. Or sudden, for example, your partner might all of a sudden stop working in one place and their resources can totally change, and they'll have to figure out a different way to make money and to contribute to the mutual resources and finances. You know, it can play out in different ways. But on another level, the 8th house is deep healing. On a psychological, emotional level, this is the house of total transformation and deep healing. And this is the house of where we keep the traumas stored from past lifetimes or from this lifetime, something that has more power over us. And Uranus is the awakener. So it can awaken you to your own power. It can revolutionize how you do, how you cope with someone taking your power away, so you can take that power back again. You can like be awakened and realize what you're doing wrong and how to empower yourself again. And there can be some deep, very sudden healing that comes in your life over the next 6-7 years. For example, imagine there is something in your life that you don't have control over, at least you've given up control. It might be an addiction of some sort. It might be any kind of situation that you feel someone has more power over you, or something, you know, that's why I mentioned addictions, maybe some health problem that you feel you have no control over and that you've given your power to. And Uranus can suddenly bring new directions or new opportunities into how to heal that situation that was so stagnant, or this, or if something had power over you, for you to take that power back. So it can work on a very healing that is sudden, let's say it like that. Healing from something that has control over you, that is sudden. It might be some trauma from the past that holds you hostage emotionally, that Uranus releases you. It's the liberator, the releaser from that. Or you might, for example, be, let's come back to the material level, you might be in some debt financially to another person. Again, it's connected to other people's resources. Uranus can suddenly liberate you through a new idea or new circumstances, not to be codependent on that person. Maybe because you're no longer reliable, maybe because you don't have access to their income anymore, or suddenly if you owe someone money, you might be able to somehow resolve that situation very fast with Uranus in the 8th house. Also, the 8th house is a house of deep intimacy, and it's considered in Western astrology sexual, the ability to connect sexually with someone. And this can be a very powerful transit if you've had some connection to another that you sexually are still, you cannot overcome. Uranus can cut the cord, as they call it. If, for example, because there is leftovers when you are intimate with someone, there are psychic leftovers that stay in our body, that even some habits that we can gain just by being sexually intimate with another person, that just because we're with them, we can start having those negative habits of theirs as well. And Uranus is a total cleanser, you know, and it can help you disconnect from such kind of connections, cores, as they say, that were created through sexual intimacy. But also on another level, if your sex life has been very Non-happening Uranus can awaken you to new adventure sexually, to new experimentation. Uranus is very experimental planet as well. The 8th house is also very occult house, and Uranus is connected to astrology, to higher knowledge. So Libras that have such inclinations can suddenly find themselves awakening to interest, to deep interest and deep and powerful realizations, because Uranus is like Eureka. You know, suddenly you have downloads on the intuitive level, because 8th house is a spiritual occult house of the subconscious. So you can have sudden realizations that release you from the past, release you from trauma, but also that bring you, if you're an astrologer, tarot reader, if you're a healer of some sort, you can totally up your game to the next level through new studies, through renewed or very powerful new interest into exploring those hidden mysteries of the 8th house. Okay, so that's what the 8th house can bring. In the worst case scenario, it can destabilize your resources, especially if they're dependent on someone else. In the best case scenario, it can give powerful sudden healings, as I said. And people that are in the occult, or people that are in research, scientific research, because it's the 8th house again, digging, who are psychologists, who work with other people's money, can have sudden rise of understanding, of knowledge, of rise in their career as well, and sudden changes there. Okay, let's focus specifically on the month of May, because we have a very beautiful configuration happening there, the whole almost month of May. In your 6th house, you have Neptune, and it's making a trine to Jupiter in your 2nd house, which is a positive aspect, the best aspect in astrology. So it means that, and this is very helpful. The trine is help from things aligning in a way that you can benefit from them, opportunities opening. And Jupiter and Neptune are both connected to through divine blessings in some way. And both the 2nd and the 6th house for you Libras are connected to the Artha houses. The Artha means material houses. One is connected to your own personal money, the 2nd house, and your resources and your sense of self-worth and your possessions and assets. The 6th house is connected to your work. So something positive can happen through your work, that it improves your resources. Or you can find a job that helps you make more money, for example. That's one way, almost like through a blessing, through a gentle opportunity that comes to you. Another way that it can play out is that maybe you can find certain resources, 2nd house, that help you complete some work project. Better quality resources, for example, whatever you're working on, that helps you complete a project in a almost perfect way. Neptune is a planet of perfection. Another way it can work out is that 2nd house rules food and what we eat. 6th house rules our health. Maybe you can, in a very gentle way, in a very natural way, without struggle, improve the quality of your food and what you're eating, with more healthy, with more living foods of some sort, that improves and directly impacts in a positive way, almost miraculous way, healing your physical body, the 6th house. So maybe if you wanted to always, for example, to start to become a vegetarian, or if you always wanted to add more fruits and vegetables to your diet, this trine aspect, it is gentle, it's not gonna force you, but it's gonna inspire you in a gentle way. And usually we're forced to make some changes in our health and our diet if something goes wrong in our health, but this time, this May, you have a rare opportunity for this to happen out of inner inspiration, or just feeling in the right place, being in the right place, in the right mood, in the right circumstances that allows you to do this right now. 6th house is also considered the house of debt, and 2nd house is our money. So you can find some solution to a debt, or do something right now, do some investment or some financial transactions that helps you with resolving a debt situation, or alleviating a debt situation. Okay, so work, material things, if you're an employer, 6th house is people that work for you, your employees. So if you're a manager, it's the people that below you that are working for you, they might help you in some way to they can bring more money to you, you know. But it's good for all financial, material situations. And as I said, Uranus is going into your eighth house and it's connected generally to your taxes, to inheritances, to other people's money. So some shifts are going to be starting there as well. You're going to start seeing like new opportunities appear or seeing that things will destabilize there. So you have to think of new ways to incorporate into your life what you can receive from others. And because the eighth house is what we receive from others, basically. Okay, and there is another interesting development that is happening in the month of May. Is Mars is going to be in its shadow period. Shadow period means in your fourth and your fifth house. It means that now first it's moving over those degrees. And then towards the end of June, it will start moving backwards. And it will be retrograde till the end of August. And then it will start moving again direct for the next month and a half after that. So you're starting like with all starting a 6 month period almost of Mars's retrograde period. But it starts even while Mars is moving direct when it's in the shadow, when it's gonna be when it's passing over the same degrees, it will become retrograde in the summer. So what does it mean? It means pay attention because it's like a setup now in May that is coming and the whole of June almost, where Mars is going to be in your fourth house and fifth house. Certain new things will appear in your life that you have to work on after that, because when Mars goes retrograde, you have to fix certain problems there. You will have to put more extra efforts in that area of your life. You'll have to maybe use some physical force or fight for something almost, or to fix something, you know, because Mars is problem solver or using a lot of extra energy when it goes retrograde. A retrograde planet requires 3 times more effort. But when it turns direct again by the end of the summer, the start of the autumn, you'd see very, hopefully you'd have improved those areas of your life, perfected them in some way, resolved certain big problems. But now it's the setup for this period. And where is it going to appear? Family, property, family relationships, the circumstances of your family, people that you live with, mother, father, or your personal family that you created, or property, land, anything to do with that. And then Mars towards the second part of May goes into your fifth house, so anything to do with your children, anything to do with your love life as well, pay attention. Creative projects of some sort as well. These are the three important things that the fifth house rules. That new setup is coming now. You start seeing new things, but when Mars turns direct, you'd have to go over them. They would require extra efforts. So what it can happen is that over the next 6 months, some of you might be fixing something at home, might be relocating, might be buying or selling property that might take longer than they expected, but will require extra efforts. But at the end of this process, you know, it will be all worth it. Mars requires 3 times more energy. Some of you might be doing like, you might require to put a lot more energy into the life of your children or into fixing some romantic problem of some sort. But now, as I said, some creative project that you might be working, because it's the two, the fourth and the fifth houses that are being affected by this Mars retrograde. But now in May is when this, you know, you probably have no idea what it's going to be now, but in May you're going to start getting an inkling. For example, you might discover a property that you really like and you're like, okay, let's get going, but then Mars goes retrograde and you realize that in order for you to buy this property, you need to fix a lot of things there, so you start renovation. So maybe in order for you to sell your property, you might have to you know, up it and renew it and making it look better, which is you'll do while Mars is retrograde. So it can play out in different ways, but now in May is the whole setup for this, for the fourth and fifth house matters. So thank you so much, Libra. Hope you enjoyed this. I will see you next month.